Hello, everybody. As I said by yours, I'm Bjoern. I will talk today a little bit about the federated sharing stuff. And I have quite a lot of slides. I will go really fast through the first few slides. This is just an overview of what federated sharing does and what we already have. So as you all know, Nextcloud is really cool that you can run your own cloud on your own home server and then have your data under your control. But of course, it creates some kind of islands because then everybody has its own Nextcloud, but you still want to share with other people. So that's why we came up with this concept of federated sharing, where then you can connect the next clouds again to share with people who are also on other servers. So what we have until now, and what probably most of you already know and already used in the past, is if you create a public link and send a link to someone else, then you can take this link and mount it to your own next cloud as a WebDAV mount, and then you can sync it with a sync client, have it integrated in your next cloud like it would be a file on the same server. And from this point on, we moved on and integrated a little bit more deeply into the whole sharing experience by introducing this cloud ID, which is your username at your Nextcloud server. And then you can add this federated cloud ID directly to the share dialog. And then over the share dialog, share directly with people on other servers. And then to make it a little bit more easy to find other people you want to share with, we introduced this concept of trusted servers. So you can either manually add some servers you decide to trust to this list, and then they will exchange the user lists so that then you can per autocomplete find users on these other servers and share with them. Or you can also say to your Nextcloud that it should be automatically manage this list. Then as soon as you create a federated share with a different user, or you accept get a share and accept it, this instance will be added as trusted Nextcloud, so that a network of known Nextcloud extends over time, and you know more and more Nextclouds and more users you can share with. What's also important, and what we changed recently in Nextcloud 10, that now federated shares have exactly the same permissions as local shares. So you can set not only read-only and read-write, which was the case before, but you can also say if the recipient should be allowed to reshare the files and stuff like this. Another nice improvement we had in Nextcloud 10 is that if you create a federated reshare, so let's say user A shares a file with user B, and then user B shares with user C, until recently, then the connection goes through all three servers, from user A to user B to user C, every time you access the file. And we changed this, that in this case, the connection, we connect directly user C with user A, so that we have direct connection with, improves the performance quite a lot. And yes, we had this feature to turn mounted public links into real federated share to give the owner more control to see who has mounted your public links and control it. So now let's go to the more interesting stuff. What's next? We have three areas where we want to work on. One is to integrate federated sharing even more into the user experience so that you don't have a difference if you have a internal share or federated share, and therefore we want to maybe change some internal stuff to always share with people with the at least internal with the complete federated share ID, and also share with groups this way, so that you can also address a group on a different server with group at server, and then say I want to share with a complete group on a different server, and this way, and then the Nextcloud would internally, when he accesses the share, decide on demand if it's internal or an external share. And maybe if this works out as we think at the moment, maybe at some point we reach even the point that you can migrate a complete user from one server to another server, and he will keep all the shares because the shares always address the complete user with his complete user ID. But of course, this is a long-term goal where we have to invest a lot of work, but that's something we want at least to try to achieve. And then, of course, the next big topic is at the moment, federated sharing is just about files, and we want to extend this to also other data you store in your next cloud. And the next obvious steps is to do the federated sharing with calendar and contact, but also with the new SpreadMe integration for communication, we also want to extend the concept of federation so that you can not only call people on the same server, but also directly say, I want to call someone who has his own next cloud on a different server. And the next point is that we want to find, my last point is that we want to make it more easy to find people, also extending the concept of trusted servers, and therefore we want to extend the user profile you have in your personal settings, where you can add much more information like your Twitter ID, your homepage, your email address, and whatever you can think of, and also want to provide you a way to verify this information so that you can verify, okay, this is really my Twitter ID or this is really my homepage, and then you can publish this on a lookup server, which we want to provide. And and on this lookup server, then people can query the lookup server and find other people to share with. Of course, this is all opt-in, so for every setting you have in your personal page, you can decide by your own if it's private information or if you want to share it on this lookup server. So this was my really quick walk through federated sharing. If you have any ideas, remarks, want to help, chat grab me on the floor or during the next days and discuss this stuff further. Thank you.